Welcome to all the viewers of Manna TV and Manna TV International. You're watching Community Special with Jyotsna. And today we have a very, very special session with another special guest of ours who are here today, who would be talking about humanitarian efforts, about some good work that they are doing to bring positive changes in the lives of people, people who are in need, to people who are struggling, people who are really troubled in the current situation. Well, I'm talking about Seva International. Seva International is an organization who has been doing great charitable work for the people in need all over the world. We have our esteemed guest here right now with me, Mr. Rajesh Sharma and Mrs. Meenal Sapre. Welcome to both of you, sir and ma'am.
Thank you.
We are very happy to have you here on Manna TV platform. And we are extremely sorry at the same time for the technical glitch that happened today. Rajesh ji, main aapse janna chahungi Seva International ke bare mein. We would like to have some information and a lot of good guidance from you about Seva International as an organization, and especially the efforts Seva International has been putting in regarding the COVID-19 situation, how, you know, you have been contributing and helping people in need in the current situation.
Yeah, sure. First of all, thank you for inviting us on Manna TV. And it's our privilege to be here, and especially with Meenal ji. I have a lot of respect for her work that she does. So being on the show with her is another additional privilege for me. I just wanted to talk, it would have been better Meenalji started, but since you asked me a question, I will give a brief answer and then we can go to Meenalji. In United States, Seva International was started in 2003. It is, in India, if you have heard about Seva Bharati, that is in 1989 that was formed there, but in US, Seva USA or Seva International as we call, was formed in 2003.
Very nice.
Currently, there are 44 chapters of Seva International that are involved in the COVID-19 efforts and all kind of relief. We are a Hindu faith, humanitarian, 501(c) nonprofit organization, as you all know. And I'll talk more about its efforts. We are experts in disaster relief, refugees welfare, family services, and also in the areas of students where we have a LEAD program. So that's just a brief introduction. We'll talk more.
Very nice. Thank you, Rajesh ji. In fact, definitely, Meenal ji, beginning to aap se honi thi, I had to start with you. But apparently, the baby spoke first, the parent had to speak. So Meenal ji, the background. About, you know, you are the central coordinator for Hindu Swayam Sevak Sangh at the HSS.
Yeah.
And we would like to know everything in detail about HSS and how Seva International is connected with HSS, or what is the reason why Seva International came into these, you know, existence. So first of all, kindly give us a little introduction about yourself and then speak about HSS.
Sure. Thank you, Jyotsnaji. Thank you for inviting me today. And Rajesh ji, thank you again for giving me the opportunity as well. So HSS is, I'm a volunteer of HSS since almost 20 years. And HSS is formed in 1989 in US. And the first chapter that was established was also in New Jersey. And now we have about 225 chapters all over USA. And right now we have, like, because of the situation, the COVID situation, we have, we usually have the weekly shakhas. It's basically the weekly chapters. The families get together. We have different sessions for different age groups. We do a lot of activities during those 1.5 hour time. Every location has their particular time when they can meet, when they can have these activities. Then we actually do a lot of sessions during that activity, including yoga, Surya Namaskar. Mm-hmm. Then we do a lot of spiritual activities, then some lectures on intellectual activities and some games is the main part when all the people, they are very excited too, and we play all the games from back home in India, and then
very nice.
Everybody is very 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 excited, and everybody is very very enthusiastic to attend these chapters. And
mm-hmm.
So basically our goal is to inculcate the good values and sanskars in every human being. And so we what we do is character building, and we give them the guidance, or whatever. We don't actually go beyond, go like separately and show them something, but the way
mm-hmm.
we conduct our programs, they are such that automatically it inculcates into your regular routine. So that's the whole, you can see right now too, with this pandemic and trying times, we have around 1,700 volunteers that are doing the seva work across USA. So, you can see none of them, nobody is hesitant of coming forward and doing whatever being asked. So we have, because of the COVID situation, we have all the shakhas, all the chapters, they are converted into e-shakhas right now, like
yes.
how
yeah.
know the Zoom calls. So we had some restrictions because when you are together it's different, and when you are on the live session it's again different, but we
yeah.
overcome that, and everybody is still excited attending the shakhas through the Zoom. And the e-shakhas also, we conduct the exact same what we do in that 1.5 hour. We do the same activities, we also play games. There is so much innovation that we come up with, like so many great ideas that we can do this, we can do that, and so it's going good. And basically the Seva International is most of the Shaka volunteers are Seva International volunteers as well. So, they started Seva International just to, it's our sister concern. And most of the Shaka HSS volunteers are part of Seva International. And many of the Seva International volunteers are basically come from HSS. So all those sanskars were already inculcated into them. So, yeah.
Very nice. Thank you so much for this detailed introduction, and information. In fact, when I was talking to Rajesh ji, wanted to do this interview, I was asking, okay, Seva International. And he says, okay, we have to call Meenal ji. So she is the central coordinator for HSS. I was confused. I was like, this is Seva International. He's talking about Hindu Swayam Sevak Sangh, HSS. What is the connect? And why is Meenal ji involved? Now I know that's the parent and that's the baby, basically. Seva International.
It's a sister organization. Yes.
Absolutely. Aap hai tabhi seva karenge. So basically, Hindu Swayam Sevak Sangh ke jo log hain, the people who are there, and the youth brigade, and everybody is so actively participating. And that's how I think Seva International is doing so great, because there are great people, great hearts, who have joined hands together. So Rajesh ji, thank you for this introduction, of course, and the details again, Meenal ji. Rajesh ji, now, when we speak about the COVID situation right now, and I definitely, got to know that you had been actively participating in helping, various organizations, as in, the healthcare providers and all, and the people in need who are poor, during COVID-19 situation. So from you, we would like to have a detailed information what recently you did during COVID-19, as an organization.
Yeah. So first I want to say this, that the minute this pandemic was identified, Seva International being the organization, we actually specialize in disaster management, disaster relief. So if you go back a few years back, we have been on forefront for the Harvey that happened in Houston area. We are still actually there in some of the areas, in some pockets of it, is still doing work, rehabilitation work. We were also in Nepal floods, Chennai floods, victims. We have been helping out in any natural calamities for years. That's where our forte is. Other than that, we do other programs, which I will talk about it later. So when this pandemic hit the United States, and specifically since we are the epicenter of this epidemic, it was very important for us to concentrate in this area and put a lot of effort. So there are four or five streams that started on the top level. I just will walk you through quickly. One was the major is about Mission Mask. Mm-hmm. Mission Mask is a very important project for us. As you can say, it was a mission for us by doing handmade masks. And the reason we did this is because the availability of the manufactured mask and anything that was manufactured was at scarcity. You cannot get that in market. There was supply shortages.
Absolutely.
And all imports, export, everything from other countries were kind of stopped. So Mission Mask is one project that we did, and we can talk more numbers and details. I can give you, I will also play one video of our volunteers.
I would love to see. If you have, yeah. Why not? Please.
Yes.
You know,
so I would like.
And it's always great, you know.
If yeah. So the these video. Are the volunteers who actually became part of this mission. And we were doing almost 1,300 masks a week.
Wow. And amazing.
We have served about more than 25 hospitals just with the handmade mask in New Jersey, New York, and Pennsylvania area. So I'll play that video. Let me just pull that video.
Sure, sure. It is amazing. 1,400 masks, handmade masks is a great
yes.
achievement, you know.
Yes.
When people were struggling to get masks. Of course, now situation is improvising, but that was a tough time when people were scrambling to get any kind of mask, actually.
Yes, absolutely. Yeah. Let Meenalji talk while I try to figure this out.
Sure, sure, sure. Meenalji, when you speak about HSS doing so many activities, the sports and other things, the, you know, other activities, from a close-knit perspective, you know, we are in tri-state area, like, of course, New York, New Jersey, mm-hmm. epicenter. We're talking about, you know, this SEWA International's efforts. How about involving the youth, the, you know, students? How is your interaction with the HSS, you know, promoting the SEWA Bhav in those students?
So we actually have a great number of youth that participate in all these activities that HSS conducts and as well as the SEWA International. So these youth, basically, they developed a Hindu Yuva helpline. And during this time, they do a lot of other activities. We have Hindu Yuva chapters in a lot of universities across US. And they basically do the shakha part in these universities. So basically, when they develop this Hindu Yuva helpline, we figured out, like, we came to know, like, there are so many stranded students or so many students that are struggling right now with different situations. You know, they are just not able to get to the groceries. They're just, you know, the accommodations or any kind of troubles that they were going through during this pandemic time because of everything has changed. The schools were closed. The colleges are shut down. You know, they had to go back. So many things were happening. So far, we have helped around 450 students across USA and about 300 in Northeast region. So we have been helping them, and and all the youth that are the volunteers of this Hindu Yuva helpline, they are also trying their best, and you know, they convey like, you know, they try whatever they can do to help these people, and they are also equally involved in all these efforts. So Hindu Yuva helpline is established, and it's working great. And there are so many stories, so many inspiring people, and so many emotional stories as well. They tell us about how we got the food, how we were, you know, without food, or, you know, we had nobody to talk to, and how frustrated they were. And, you know, so many stories that sometimes we do have all those clips, but when we have more time, maybe, you know, we can.
No, we would definitely love to see all those clips and everything. Even if we don't get them right now, we can always get them later on. And we would like to incorporate them, you know, in our other sections of the videos. So,
you
got this clip?
Yeah, okay. I think I got the clip. Let me just...
Sure. So Rajesh Ji is about to show us a clip, you know, about how their team, you know, they made 1,400 handmade masks, cloth masks, you know, that they distributed, you know, during the COVID, you know, situation, basically.
Good job, good job. Doing a good job, don't get too down. The world needs you now. Know that you matter.
So beautiful, you know. What I noticed was, from young to old, from boys to girls, men and women, everybody equally participated. It is so wonderful to look at those, you know, happy smiles, you know, happy faces doing such a wonderful work, you know, taking out their time, you know, precious time to do something good for the humanity, basically. Thank you for great efforts, you know. Well, thank you to Seva International for extending that helping hand.
Yeah, this is a thank you to the volunteers. That's why I wanted to play it here.
Because
this is a good platform for them to know that how much it means to us.
Sure. I mean, it's so good to see there were small kids, you know, there. And then there are old ladies as well, you know. Yeah. You know, everybody is participating at the same level of, you know, excitement and that, you know, willingness to do something. So we appreciate that. So about, I was, you know, like, of course, when I was talking to you previously, you were saying that there is some drive coming up in Edison area also. Can you please throw some light about that?
Right. So on Sunday, this Sunday, 31st of May, from 9 a.m. to 11 a.m. on the Oak Tree Road, if you know where the Chili's are, we go behind the parking lot, the large parking lot. We are doing a drive-through food distribution. We will be distributing about 500 packets. That includes 8 pounds of rice, 4 pounds of lentils, and 1 liter of cooking oil. So this will be in the package that people who are suffering in this tough time, trying time, this is a small thing that we could do for them. And so they can come. They are welcome to come. Our number is, I think you will show that number. I'll show the flyer.
So you can always speak out the number as well.
Yeah, 702-900-SEVA. 702-900-SEVA. This is Central New Jersey Helpline, and you can call in to get any details on this program. This helpline does much more than that, just so that you know. You can call, senior citizens can call if they need groceries, as Meenalji was talking about. Awesome. These youths that we have from HSS and the HSS team, they're actually delivering food at your house. So if you cannot go out, you have any physical disability, or you are afraid of going out because of the your age factors, please call this number, 702-900-SEWA.
So 702-900-SEWA, SEWA.
Yes. That's all. SEWA, yes. And so this drive is on Sunday, mm-hmm. May 31st.
Timings? Any particular timings?
Yes. Please come 9 a.m. to 11 a.m.
Okay.
We have first come, first serve basis. If you need more information, again, you can call us.
So anybody can come, but yes, we would request people who are in real need should go. If you are able to purchase your stuff, you buy it from stores. But the people who generally need it right now, they must go and get these things from Edison area. This is Oak Tree Road, nearby Oak Tree Road. There is a Chili's complex, what you call
behind
it, the cinemas complex and all. Behind Chili's, is, I think there are some grocery outlets also. It's there, I believe, that
correct. Meenalji can talk about, we are also doing the groceries for students, as Meenalji talked about, but to other people.
We would definitely like to know more about that. When you know, when you were talking about the helpline number, even speaking about the elderly people who cannot go out for their own groceries, and if you know, SEWA International is extending help there and HSS is extending the help there, please throw some light. That will be a great help for a lot of people. Even, you know, the situation is still not good here. And for the elderly, it is going to take a long time. And we really need to support them in and out every day. So Meenalji, please throw some light there.
Rajeshji already shared the number. So whoever is in need, they can call on that number. And we have been doing this. We have a case management, like, you know, we prepare this Excel where we get these calls, we allocate it area wise, and then people go buy the groceries or whatever their needs are. Sometimes they need just the medical advice, just the medical help. We direct their calls accordingly. And then that's how we try to help these people. They are not just elderly people. They could be anybody. We also help some of the COVID sufferers who are actually going through the COVID, but they are home and they are just self-isolated. They don't have anywhere to go. They don't have any means to get to the groceries. So for those people also, we have served, we have delivered the groceries. We took the utmost care. We worked with the you know, we tried to be very, very careful, cautious, dealing with this type of situations, and it worked out very well with us. They really appreciate all of our efforts, and that's all we want to do in this trying times. So,
very nice. So, it's so nice of you when you speak about the sick patients, you know, and you're catering to them, sending food to them, groceries and everything, you know. This is something, a very responsible act, you know. Not everybody would think from that perspective, okay, there are sick people in that family, in that area, okay, serve them, you know, cater to them. First of all, it really needs guts to go to that house, you know, walk up to that community or level where the infestation is high. And I would personally like to thank you, because there was a, you know, I in fact had shared some information, and I was live the other day, and I was speaking about one of the community in the Edison area where the infestation was too high, and those sick patients were eventually going out. And when they were going out, what was happening is their neighbors were calling upon police 911 and telling, hey, these are the sick people, they're going out to get food or whatever, they are roaming out free. And in that situation, I did left a message, you know, on Facebook. It was my personal view, though, speaking that we need to help them. And immediately I got calls from the team of SEWA International, from the team of HSS. And immediately, you know, they called me and they said, Jyotsna ji, please give us those address, that community's name. We are ready to go right away. We will supply everything that the people need. This is what we've been doing. Mm-hmm. And this is a first-hand account. I can very much relate, you know, how good and how effective and how, you know, instant help that you provide, I have personally witnessed. So great work. In fact, thank you for that great work, you know, you're doing.
Dhanyavaad. So sometimes, like, you know, initially it wasn't that easy. It was all chaotic because initially we were getting so many calls and we weren't streamlined anything because everything was new for us as well. So, you know, it was like very overwhelming. But eventually within like 3 to 5 days, we kind of streamlined the whole situation, and slowly and gradually we were able to get control of it. But in mid-March or towards the end of March, the situation was really, really bad and even getting worse day by day. So it was really difficult times at that time, but I'm very, very proud, or I'm very, very lucky to say that we have such dedicated volunteers, and who were just with one, you know, request, they would go out. They would take all the precautions that's needed. We suggested everybody. Seva International was very good with that. They provided us with all the equipments like the mask, the gloves, everything. And they were insisting on not leaving the house without using all these things. And we were making sure that everybody who is going out and helping out or buying groceries or doing any kind of outside work, even for masks, we needed the materials to purchase when the Mission Mask Project started. So all those things were taken care of. And fortunately, we can say that we are very lucky to have all these volunteers who took care of themselves, so they were able to take care of others in the community as well.
Yes. We are very appreciative of your efforts and all this, you know. Rajesh ji, I have a very particular question, you know. Seva International, you're doing so many things. I mean, I saw your update on the recent cyclone that came in India, Amphan. And as you said, disaster relief. You are extending this help worldwide. It's not just localized here. Although you're sitting here in the USA, your heart is connected with the whole world. And wherever there is a distress, the Seva International is, you know, reaching out. Yes. Throw some more light there, you know.
So currently, Seva International is in about 20 to 22 countries. US is not only one of it. We are in Sri Lanka, we are in Nepal, we are in Pakistan, we are in Colombia. We are doing a large project in Colombia that is managed by our North New Jersey chapter. And we are providing education. And in some areas where remote areas where there's no electricity, we actually have provided solar panel electricity in those areas and trying to get the local populations to get educated. So that's a big project in Colombia. In current COVID situation, we have supplied food in Pakistan. We have also helped out in Nepal. Recently, I just saw some picture because Atlanta chapter is the one which is doing mostly external on the countryside, on the external foreign countries from here. Some pictures from Bangladesh also where we provided the food. So this is outreach in general. What I want to also talk about is two more very important, two small things, helpline that we talked about. Mm-hmm. One is Central New Jersey that I talked about. There is every East Zone, West Zone has their own helpline. What we also did, not only just the food side of it, what were happening is a lot of visitors who came from India, like parents, grandparents, they couldn't go back. And in some scenario, their medicine ran out, their prescription ran out.
Wow.
So what we have is a panel of physicians on our helpline. And what we do is if you called in and you ask for your parents' prescription, usually consulate does it. But this year, because of the amount of calls they were getting, we were helping out consulate in these scenarios. And we had physicians on call. If you call us and we will get you a physician online within 5 to 10 minutes, and they will write a prescription. You know, you just need to identify your passport number, your visa, things, important documents, so they can identify and send the prescription to a pharmacy. So we did that. On other side, there were immigration issues, like some people were stuck and their visas expiring. Those cases, we have legal advisors on our helpline. So like doctors panel, We have a legal advisors panel, 10, 15 lawyers, who are only helping out in scenario of this nature, that if my visa has expired, I'm overstaying, what do I do? So you can call this helpline still. We help out with those scenarios because we have doctors online. It helps a big time. Sometimes people are calling that, oh, I am coughing. And I, you know, it's just anxiety that is there. So when they talk to a doctor, which is on our panel, they get a little bit of comfort. They don't feel like that they, you know, everybody thinks they have symptoms, right? If they're a little bit cough, it's but natural human nature. But what we try to do is not to send them to the, they go, they get a screening done, they talk to a doctor. Doctor will say, okay, I'll prescribe you some. It's not that. So that was another helpline feature. The other helpline that we had is for COVID plasma registry. This is very unique that SEWA did, where donors and recipient are on the same platform. And again, we have panel of doctors. So if a person had COVID and they're COVID free for 14 days, they could go register as a plasma donor.
So very nice.
This is the first registry in the country that went live about 2 months back. And we are helping about, you know, I think, I don't know about exact number, but about 70 to 80 COVID patients were matched within a couple of weeks or so.
Wow, this is amazing.
Yes. So this is called COVID, SEWA COVID Plasma Registry. And it has donors and recipient. If you are infected with the disease, you can go register that I need the plasma. If doctor recommends, then you can go through that process. So that's another big milestone that SEWA International had.
This is one of the biggest milestones, I would say, for the current situation, saving lives, you know, because plasma donation, plasma registry, and you were the first ones to start, you know, that itself is exemplary, you know, and then people join hands. And you, 80 lives you have saved, you know, doing plasma donation. This is something, a long blessing will go to SEWA International, you know. I mean, long list of blessings, you know. Thank you. This is real work SEWA International is doing. And we feel proud, you know, and privileged to have you as our guest today on Mana TV platform for that reason.
Meenalji can share more experiences on the... HSS did a lot of seminars, and she can talk about webinars on those, which is very interesting.
I mean, I'm here to learn more about HSS, about SEWA International, and of course, I would need more inputs from you as to how general public can, you know, connect with you, lend you a helping hand in forms of donations or services or, you know, whatever time they can do it. So, of course, first, yes, details from you, and then we will go to those details as well.
So so we actually had like a lot of organizations came together, and we started a program called SEWA Diwali a couple of years back, where we, during the Diwali time, we collected food. It was basically a food drive, and it started in New Jersey, and then it extended to other states in Northeast. And for the first year, we did it in 2018. And at that time, around 40 plus organizations joined hand. And we named it sevadiwali.org. And it was under one umbrella that we were able to collect so much of, I guess, first year, we collected about 18,000 pounds of food and donated to food pantries across New Jersey. And 2019, we did the same thing. And people were very, very excited to do that again. And during the Diwali time, of course, everybody wants to do something for the community. And they were all looking for something. They had no idea that what can be done. But when they found about this, it was really very well taken. And it was then when this, during March, when this thing started, it was... for us, it wasn't really that difficult because we were already connected with 40 plus organizations in New Jersey. And so we immediately created a response team. And right now, too, with this, with the help of other community and many, many individuals, we started an online campaign, fundraising campaign called SEWA for Community. And we raised almost $130,000 across Northeast.
Amazing.
And we actually in New Jersey itself, we collected about $50,000, and we donated to 12 food pantries in New Jersey, half of the Amazing. Money from there. And then we purchased the PPE supplies and masks and you know, all that through Seva International, and we donated it to about 16 hospitals across New Jersey, New York. And then the remaining 15,000 is there are a lot of Nepali bandhus we have mm-hmm. In this area, and you know, they are going, they're low income, they are they're struggling a lot. So like, this is a recent development within like past 2-3 days. We were able to, with the help of all these organizations, we were able to raise almost $15,000. And I'm very, very proud to say this, that, you know, those 150 students or 50 families are now covered for next 3 months with the donations or with the money that raised in past 2-3 days. So I'm really, people are just amazing, and, you know, they get inspired. If you do something, they all want to do something. So it's like, chain kind of a thing. So it's really very, very
fly fast.
Yes.
It is like a fission reaction, Minalji, the way you're doing, you know, the great work you're doing. See, in today's scenario, people, you know, want to contribute to the genuine organizations.
Mm-hmm.
And personally speaking, there was a lot of struggle I would see that had happened, you know, in the sense people were not even aware where should they donate.
Yes.
And that itself is a, you know, handicap. If you don't know where to donate, even though you want to help, you can't do anything.
Mm-hmm.
And then a fashion trend started. Where people started donating food for the hospitals. It's a good thing. And I personally appreciate that efforts that people started off with. But apparently what we got to know from most of the hospital staff was that there were so many people going in the unidirectional approach, only sending food to all hospitals, healthcare workers. Mm. The food was literally getting trashed. The hospital authorities told us, you know, to our known connects, that they doctors are not eating as much food as much as being delivered every day. And they're literally trashing that food every day.
Mm-hmm.
That is something that pains a lot. People have put in money. People mm-hmm. have put in efforts.
Mm-hmm.
You get a food made from some, you know, outlet, and then you go and deliver all the way out. And then it gets trashed, no relevance. But when people get to know where organizations like Seva International are there, where you are taking the food items, the donations, you know, to the food pantries, to the real needy people, to mm-hmm. the people who are like patients, to the people who are like old people, yeah. That is where the real Seva comes in place. There was another fashion that trended, you know, donating. You're going and donating food to these outlets, to these services, you know, rather not outlets, I correct myself. They go to these hospitals and, you know, the healthcare services, they're donating, they're getting a picture clicked, you know, and then they showcase a certificate that they get from the hospital. Now, this is something that needed a correction. Because if all 100 people go in the same direction, of course, there are only fixed number of hospitals. There are fixed number of healthcare services. There are fixed number of heroes in the front line. But then there are infinite number of people in need. People mm-hmm. who are not listed. People who are not identified. People who do not want to come in front. Because if they come in front, they feel, oh, my respect will go down. I personally have known cases where it was a very short level drive when some people did. So the friend of a lady came and said, I cannot disclose my friend's name or her details, but she is in distress. She is a cancer patient. She has 3 kids. She's unemployed. We need supplies for their home, grocery for them, supplies for them. That is where, that strike the chord, you know, what you're doing is that. these are the needy people where the money, where the resources, where the efforts are going in the right direction. And that's where the real blessings will come to you people, honestly. So I'm very, very thankful, you know, personally, and on behalf of Mana TV also, for, you know, organizations like you are doing great work, real sense, that's actually reaching the most needy people. So I definitely need inputs from you as to how, now when I was saying how to, you know, get attached with you. There are a lot of people who are asking, where do we put in the money? Where do we donate? What is the link? Who's the organization? Where I can do and go do seva? Yeah. Then you need to throw light there now, how they can, you know, tag along with you.
So, Meenaji, can I take this one?
Yeah, okay. Sure.
Thank you. So, good that you asked that question. And in the flyer, if you saw me, I have asked you to post a URL, and that URL is sevausa.org/neighborhoodseva.
Rajeshji, if you have it on your screen, you can again, you know, share the flyer with us right now. It's not
the flyer that you had created, that the same flyer I meant to say. Okay, but no, yes, I will share that.
That's a promotional flyer. But yes. Maybe if you have something else with you, with your other slides, you are most.
I can navigate to that website when we get. I actually want to play video after this, but first let me. So Neighborhood Seva is exactly that.
Sure.
What that does is, if you go to sevausa.org/neighborhoodseva, you can register as a volunteer. It doesn't matter which part of the country you are in. You just have to register your name, your address, and based on that, you will get to one of the chapters out of the 44 chapters that are there attached to that particular chapter, and somebody will reach out to you.
Perfect. And so I would want you to reiterate again. So they go to the Seva International's website.
Yes. SevaUSA.
Okay, SevaUSA.org/
Neighborhood Seva, SEWA. So Neighborhood, right. SEWA. This is one word, Neighborhood, okay. Seva.
Right.
So this program, we really did this program because there's a lot of requests coming that we want to do something with Seva. We want to work with you guys. What can I do? How can I help you? So
right.
We said, you know, you can be part of it. That's how simple as this. Go register yourself and become part of the local chapter and start doing the help, the programs that we run, be part of it.
Very good.
Second thing that, since you asked about the people who needs it, one of our very popular program, which we run in New Jersey, one of the best program, I would say, is about high school students.
Mm-hmm.
So it's called LEAD program. It's a very popular program. So in LEAD program, which means leadership, teaching right. leadership and, you know, development, high school kids can join us in a LEAD program, and they do about 100 to 200 hours of community service. And usually we go to Kitty Keep Well Camp, which is underprivileged kid thing. We go to Edison Chapter, many places that we go. We do community gardens. We also have adopted Route 27 in Natashan for 2.5 miles.
Very
so
nice.
We do this community service, and what they do is they become part of community. They develop a sense of belonging in the community and how to keep connected with their community. Okay. And in turn, they get awarded for if they need community hours, we can give them certificate of community hours. They can also apply for various awards that are available at the national level.
This is amazing. So basically, sorry, I'm interrupting you here. When yes. you speak about giving them the hours, the certificate for the hours. So basically, when the schools, you know, in schools here in the education system, the students are required to have some volunteer hours, you know, serve the volunteer hours, you know, basically.
Yeah.
So if they attach with Seva International, and if they are able to work for those 100 or 200 hours, they will be given a certificate from Seva International?
Yes, we get the certificate from Seva right. International. And there are other certificates we also give depending on what they have done. There mm-hmm. are other certificate we apply, which is national level certificates.
So very nice. Anything for the middle schoolers as well? Or basically, it's always in the high school that these certificates are required, or even middle schoolers can come?
When we do projects like we are cleaning up a garden or we are doing a community mm-hmm. garden, usually siblings come along, the younger sibling mm-hmm. comes along, right. The parents are volunteering too. So there is no restriction as such, but for the LEAD program, they are independent. In the sense, we mm-hmm. could take them on a trip, the parents don't have to stick around, and the older kids do the things on their own kind of thing in this environment. That's the only difference.
Nice.
Yeah. I wanted to play one video of acknowledgement from a hospital.
Sure, please. We would like to see, absolutely.
Yeah.
Acknowledgements are many, I know, for yes, we would like to see the acknowledgement from the hospital.
Yeah, let me try this.
Sure. Today, technology really played a great funny game with us.
Yeah, I know. I'm trying to. I'm also a little bit behind on this, but let me see.
Well, that's fine.
Hello, my name is Vanessa Warner, and I'm one of the administrators at St. Mary's General Hospital in Passaic, New Jersey. And I'm here today to thank you so sincerely for the wonderful donations you've given our hospital. These donations have helped protect the lives of our healthcare workers as they work to save the lives of others. I'm going to introduce you to some of them now.
Hello, my name is Dr. Stanley Sweat. I'm director of the cardiac cath lab at St. Mary's General Hospital. Myself and my staff would like to personally thank all the people who have donated the N95 masks to not only protect us and our patients that we do procedures on, but the rest of the public.
Hi, my name is Joe Verouette. I'm the director of purchasing at St. Mary's Hospital. I would like to thank CEWA for their donation of N95 masks that I'm able to supply to my nursing staff. And once again, it is greatly appreciated. Thank you.
This is so good.
Yeah, we are. So this is just an acknowledgement.
Doctors had the biggest trouble of, you know, getting the basic PPE stuff, you know, and the earliest you sent it, that was the biggest help. After that, things are streaming up, you know, falling in place. But you stood up in action when there were very few, you know, volunteers there doing this. We are so thankful to you for that.
Yeah. So what I want to add here, though we delivered the N95, most of the time, our volunteers from HSS were the one who were on the ground going to this hospital, which we knew are dealing with the COVID patient. So I want to thank all those volunteers who actually stepped up. We just were packaging, putting the stuff. They took the card, they went to the hospital. Right. And delivering in those situations is itself a challenge. And
absolutely. You
know, I applaud their effort at this point. I want to thank them for helping us out.
Absolutely, absolutely. Big thanks to them, because it takes a big heart and courage to go out of your house.
Yes.
When you know the infestation, the infection is spreading at the, you know, worst level. And that time, these volunteers went to these hospitals to deliver these PPE kits. That itself is commendable. I mean, you know, hats off to the parents who allowed their kids to go out and do this. Hats off to the adults who went risking their life, because everybody had to safeguard their life. And then organizations like Seva International, people like Mr. Rajesh Sharma, people like Mrs. Meenal Sapre, they are there in the front line, standing right next to the needy, without caring for their lives, without caring for their own health. This takes a big, big heart and a courage. So this is amazing. Commendable, very commendable to work.
I think Meenalji has to talk about the food pantries, because that's her favorite topic. talked about yet.
The whole concept of this show has turned a little bit, because I really don't know what all you do. And I'm eager to listen from you more and more. And every time one of you is opening the, file, there is a new topic coming, whether it is the student volunteers hours, whether there are different countries associated, whether there is a food pantry, whether there was a mask drive, whether there is a disaster relief. So I'm like, okay, I have to listen today. So I'm like, okay, I'm waiting for the next one. What's there now? What's the treasure coming out through, say, International HSS?
Yes.
Yeah, so when we collected all this food, I mean, all this fundraising efforts were done through a Facebook online campaign. We had we have collected all the money. We distributed it
You have a
among.
sorry to interrupt. So when you say Facebook online account, do you
Yes.
have a Facebook page?
We had a Facebook page, Seva for Community NJ, and then it got extended to other states as well. So everybody, all states had it under Seva for Community, and then they would put New York or New Jersey or
Okay,
Pennsylvania.
so you have Seva for Community Facebook page, and
Yes.
then you would have distributions as in area wise, like New York, New Jersey, and state
Yes.
wise, basically, for
Yes.
the
Yeah.
Seva for Community
Yeah.
chapters, there,
Yeah,
pages,
and
basically.
that's where we collected almost $130,000across Northeast, and we distributed it among several food pantries. In New Jersey itself, we distributed it to 12 food pantries. I mean, I can name
Nice.
them: Elijah's Kitchen, Mac Foods, Rise, Trenton Area Soup Kitchen. This was all done with the help of Seva International. So we basically took their help to cut the checks. We all the volunteers, the area coordinators in those particular areas, they asked for what the need is. And with these situations, they, even though they had whatever they required on their websites and everything, it was hard for us to get the stuff because there were other requirements with the individual the cases. So it wasn't possible for the volunteers to get what they actually need. So we decided to donate it in
Right, food
like
pantries.
fund donations. So with the help of Seva International, we did do the donation, money donations. We asked for the requirements, and we accordingly we looked at their what are the needs, and how many people do they actually feed. And right now, when we go over all the statistics, it feels like it has extended, it has increased a lot because of the situation. And it's like, even if they were feeding like maybe 100 families previously, now it's like 10 times more because of the schools are closed and a lot of students are on the streets, and
Absolutely.
they were depending on the meals that the schools were providing. So all the burden is coming under the food pantries of all the townships. So we did all that math, and we distributed per requirements, and we have some of the pantries, they actually have a lot of pantries covered in their area. So we give them the chunk of money, so they know what are their priorities, and that's how they distributed the cash. So yeah, so that's we are very, and then we got
Nice.
all these emails and messages and so many emotional feedback from the for example, from North Brunswick High School. They were literally on the verge of there was no food for those students, and they were
Wow.
literally like, yeah, it was like tremendous efforts from all the Seva for Community. It's there are many, many individuals and organizations that come together to do this. It's not just the HSS efforts or Seva International. There are a lot of organizations are behind this. But yeah, yes, when we asked for help, because we have done a few programs before, they were ready to participate. They were on their there was no hesitation at all. And we were able to drive this through. So
Very
right now the
nice.
food right now the Seva for Community fundraising campaign is closed, as far as I know, in New Jersey and most of the other states as well. But the other efforts will still continue. On the side, we, as I said, in last couple of days, we raised for these Nepalese bandhus, and we are going to do the same things. But for the food pantries, right now it's been halted, and we will see if the need arises, we might do it. We have the sevaforcommunity.org website, so if you get a chance, if you want to go over there and check it out, all the stats are over there, and we have all the information. We also have a place where you can put in your request if you want to help. You can put that information over there, and we can get back to you. And you can be, we need people. This situation is such that It's always, there is always a need. So,
right.
You know, if anybody is willing to participate or anybody is willing to do whatever they can, we will provide all the needed information or all the needed equipments and everything, and we can direct them in whatever their areas of interest are.
Very nice, very nice. Pretty much complete, exhaustive information, you know, like detailed information that you have given. Thank you. So I know, I mean, there were phases where you had run those campaigns and you collected donations. But understanding the fact that Seva International is doing so good, genuinely, you know, helping out people, it's the right philanthropy that you're executing. How can somebody donate? If they just want to donate to Seva International, your wish, wherever you want to use those resources, how can they do that?
So sevausa.org, you can go and click on donate. That's the simplest way you can do. When you donate, there are options you can donate. So for example, one of our very popular project is called Sponsor a Child.
Wow.
What that provides is for a $20 a month.
Right.
It will be providing facility to a kid anywhere in India, Pakistan, Bangladesh, Sri Lanka, wherever our programs are for the kids. It enables them to have the facility that a kids need. It could be any supplies, school material, whatnot. So that $20 goes a long way. So what you could do is you could go and you can do a $240 lump sum payment, or you can do $20 per month through your credit cards. You can also do bigger, like we have a high worth donors. So they go in a different category who run bigger projects. They say, I want to do certain projects in certain areas. And accordingly, they donate money through different channels and projects. Also, we have another for women empowerment. We have a women hygiene and toilet project that's going on in India. For that also, you can donate through the same link that I said, sevausa.org. There are multiple options, multiple projects. You can do for Columbia project. You can do just for a general fund. So you say, I don't know which projects I want to do it. I just want to donate general fund. You can click on general fund and donate.
This is such a wonderful setup, you know, when people have choice to donate whatever they want to donate for, whether it's women, whether it's about children, you know, sponsoring a child, whether it's some other disaster relief. And it is so well planned, you know, like you have executed everything in a stepwise manner, you know. Okay, you want to do this, go to this, you can do this. You want to get associated with us, okay. You want to bring your kids in, fine. This is something very unique of Seva International as an organization, I must say that.
Yeah, there's a lot of volunteers behind the scene that are working to do this, all this thing happen, you know. There are many volunteers that are different areas. There is marketing team, there is IT team behind it. And we all come together and, you know, try to do the best, whatever is to help the community.
Rajesh ji, when I began the program, I forgot to take your introduction. You are a treasure trove of information. Kindly give us your introduction, because it is not just that Mr. Rajesh Sharma is the only central coordinator for New Jersey. He is more than that. Little background about you, Rajesh ji, your experience, and why did you get connected with Seva International?
So the answer is very simple. And I think Meenal ji gave that answer, that most of the volunteers who come in Seva come from HSS. So I am a foot soldier from HSS. And I was a Seva Pramukh for many years with HSS. And then I was told to take responsibility to do Seva International work. And that's how I switched from. I started doing more Seva International work. Other than that, I'm an engineer by profession, and I graduated from Indian Institute of Technology, Kanpur. I taught briefly in Philadelphia in Drexel University, and then I've been working on financial sector for over 20 years now. Currently, I'm an enterprise architect at a Federal Reserve Bank.
Really?
And, you know, I live in Bethancourt with my wife, my two kids, and we have a old English bulldog that we live with, Doppler. So that's about me, other than Seva thing that I can share.
So nice. Beautiful.
Thank you.
In fact, because I feel like you have been associated with the organization, been doing such an extensive work, risking your life, of course, you know, when you go to the front and help as frontline warriors, you too are frontline warriors. When you go out to help those frontline warriors, you also become frontline warrior. And you have a profession, you know. Like, everybody is hibernating, but there are some heroes like you who are going out, managing your work, your profession, your family, and then the mankind, the altruistic hearts, the philanthropy that you have. That is exemplary. And I'm very, very sure the Hindu Swayam Sevak Sangh as an organization has imbibed those solid values in all their team members, the volunteers who are associated, the family, the extended family of HSS. And I know, I mean, there is a lot to speak more, and I would definitely like to keep inviting you in our next sessions. But yes, before that, Hindu Swayam Sevak Sangh as an organization, I want a little more philosophical and ideological concept clarification there. When people speak about Hinduism, you know, I mean, there is a lot of rhetoric which is against Hindus as is, you know. People speak about some organization, which is like Hindu, and then Swayam Sevak Sangh, of course, you know, or RSS, right? So what happens is people tend to think differently, or I would say the liberals, extra liberals, think differently about such organizations. Well, I'm very sure they might have clarified a lot of their doubts about the organization. But yes, it's an ideology about Hindu Swayam Sevak Sangh, the roots. Can you throw some light on that, Meenalji or Rajeshi, anyone?
I think Meenalji is best suited. I will definitely add some point once Meenalji finishes.
Sure.
Yes.
So basically, we do follow the ideology from RSS, but it's a separate organization, individual organization. So outside of Bharat, there are a lot of countries who have established Hindu Swayam Sevak Sangh. And we do follow the ideology, but it's the structure is kind of different. We do have a family shakhas over here, so families come together, and you know they do enjoy the activities. There are several parts of character building exercises that we do, so those are also conducted at individual needs or individual shakha levels. So I guess it's a different, definitely different than what we do. I mean, I don't know why the misconceptions are there, but they are there, and it has nothing to do with the name, I guess. It's just no matter what you do, it's going to be there always. So we don't go out. I think this would be probably the few programs that we even talk about, what we are doing as a seva or anything. We just do what we are supposed to do. And, it doesn't matter, because at the end of the day, we can see people are getting, people appreciate what we do. And that's what
they're being helped by you.
Yes, that's what is needed right now in the community. Our ideology is the Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam. So the whole world is our, family. So we just continue doing what we are supposed to do.
This is such a beautiful explanation you said. I mean, I was coming to that. It is Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam. Yes. Hinduism as a way of life, Hindu religion. It's Hinduism is a way of life. And in this way of life, we profess, or Hindus profess, Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam, where the whole universe is our world. And when the whole universe is our world, we cut across the barriers of race, caste, creed, and everything. This is the beauty of the organization, ASSIS.
Yes.
Amazing. Amazing. Thank you so much.
Rajesh, if you want to add anything, please.
Yes, I do want to add a few more. Do we have time or we are
all yours? I mean, you know, unfortunately we started a little late. Yes, you have. And
because I at the end I do want to play one more video from our lead.
Sure.
He's an excellent singer.
To our viewers also, I'm sorry interrupting there. To our viewers also, yes, we are live on Mana TV, Mana TV International right now. And we are on the Facebook page of Mana TV. And we are also available on the YouTube link as well now, I believe. So there was a technical glitch. Right now, I mean, we are everywhere on all the platforms. And I feel happy. I'm sorry for all the people who tried calling me and I could not take their calls. There were a lot of calls of appreciation and messages that came in. And we would like to thank. In fact, a caller called me. She was very happy and appreciative of what, Seva International is doing and HSS is doing. And happens to be a resident of Edison. And she said, I am so thankful to Seva International because my son is involved in the Seva activities. And through that channel and platform, he's learning the basic essence of humanity. How kids should be involved in helping others. The development of empathy, that's the development of leadership skills. That's what you're giving. She was appreciating that today when she called me. In fact, because there was a technical glitch, so we delayed our program a little bit. And she called me and she conveyed this message.
So just to touch upon the point that we were discussing, Seva International, and I said this in the initial introduction, is a Hindu faith organization. The reason we say that is the shloka that Meenalji just told you, Vasudev Kutumbakam. That's one thing, that whole world. And the second is Sarve Bhavantu Sukhina. We want happiness for the whole world. We are not here to identify and exclude or include certain people. So one thing that in our lead program that I talk about high school, we have kids from all caste, creed, and things. So we don't differentiate. And this question never comes up. They know what we are doing. We have gone into community and the kind of work we are doing. Recently, I was talking to a person from the Middlesex County office, and she told me, I just find out that Seva International is doing so much for COVID. I did not know that you guys do this much. And I told, this just happened because some newspaper recently, we did a PPE drive where we drive through, like we're doing for food, we did for manufactured PPE. We distributed about 30,000 in Metachan, and pretty much all first responder from about 30, 40 agencies came and picked up the PPE. And they realized and they said, so I told them that we do work, but it's just that sometime we are not as Meenalji said, go on any programs and try to advertise the program. So that's I just wanted to add.
And you're a very humble and modest organization, I must say that. There's no much of glitter, to show or show the overzealous things. Okay, yes, we are doing. This is what it is. You are so humbly doing things, and we are getting to know through our friends and connections or, community people who say, okay. And in fact, I did get a note from certain offices of the physicians, small offices of physical therapists and physicians and chiropractors, where you have been able to give them the PPE kits while they were scrambling to get the supplies they couldn't get online or anywhere. And you as an organization have extended help to them by providing them the face shields, masks, gloves, and all those things. So this is something great, as a community, when you say neighborhood watch or neighborhood help.
Neighborhood
Seva. Neighborhood Seva, yes. So you are helping them from that perspective is also great. In fact, if you have to convey some message to those, physicians and all those offices, small offices who are still scrambling, you can definitely convey a message to them if they can reach out to you and take help from you about these, products.
Yeah. So like I said, the helpline number is 702-900-SEWA. 702-900-SEWA. You can also go on Twitter and tweet for help at Jersey Seva. So those two things, you can reach out to us and we will be more than happy to help you out, especially in this time, trying time. Any call to us is very valuable. We want to help out. We have a lot of people out there that can go out and try to help. At last, I will play one video from one of our lead students. Meenalji can also speak and I'll try to see if I can do this one.
Please, play the video. And Meenalji and Rajeshji, I must thank you, for the great information, for enlightening all of us about the good work the HSS and the, the Seva International is doing, basically. So whenever you are ready,
Rajeshji,
we are waiting for your video.
Yes, absolutely.
Yeah. I missed one point when we were talking about the youth.
All right.
So there were like a lot of UAs who are actually actively participating in these efforts, right? So they have they innovated some ways of raising funds. So some of them were actually teaching dance and, some of them are actually, and whatever money they collect from there, they all will be donated. So, there were a lot of viewers who are actually very, very dedicated and they come up with the creative ideas. And even in some of the chapters in South Jersey and in Atlantic City and all, they also did some fundraising with just the help of all the teenagers. And, they also did the videos that could be sent to the first responders. So, they just to cheer them up, the situation is not that great. So, they are doing their whatever they can. Yeah. Yeah, so I was like, I have to mention it.
You are creating a new generation, of people who would have love and empathy for this world.
Mm-hmm.
And this itself is a very commendable task. And you're creating leaders for tomorrow, leaders who will care for the world. अपने लिए तो सब जीते हैं जब दूसरों के लिए जीना सीखते हैं हम तब हम इस दुनिया को सुंदर बनाते हैं अच्छा बनाते हैं तो आप उसके लिए हम आपको बहुत बधाई देते हैं वी कमेंड यू एंड वी सैल्यूट यू फॉर द वर्क दैट यू आर डूइंग इन दैट डायरेक्शन एंड यस राजेश जी
मीनल जी यू हैड ऑल्सो अलोंग विद योर युवास वी डिड द फर्स्ट रिस्पोंडर्स ब्रेकफास्ट लंच आई थिंक यू डिड द You want to talk about that 2 seconds and then I'll play the video.
Yeah, right. so many of the chapters did provide the meals just to appreciate them. As Jyotsnaji was saying earlier, it wasn't like bombarded to them, like, okay, we are sending you food and all that. We took enough precautions. We only provided whatever was required. All the chapters worked on, the HSS chapters, they worked on it. They asked for the needs. They asked for how many people are currently in the offices. And even doing this, they tried to help the local businesses that are also struggling because of the situation, and they don't have any the takeouts and the dining in is all stopped, so only the takeouts are working. So with that, at least they tried to help these local businesses providing breakfast, and they asked them to make it for them. So it was very well received, and we have like tremendous response from the from all these first responders, EMTs, EMS, and hospitals, and we did get nice thank you from all of them. And to them, we have sent the nice clips from all the little kids from our chapters. And
very nice.
It was encouraging and very inspiring for them also. Like, they literally had, some of them had tears in their eyes. Oh, this is so wonderful. And, so it was some of the townships were really in need of all these things. Some we can say, probably just got overwhelmed with the food and everything, but I guess it was still a good way of appreciating them, what they are doing in this situation. So I guess it was well taken.
Very nice. Rajeshji, and now we're waiting for your clip.
Yes, so here you go.
Hi guys, it's Mahathi Chitty, and this is Fight Song by Rachel Platten. And first of all, I want to thank Seva International for providing me with a platform to use my voice to give hope to our healthcare workers, and a thanks to our healthcare workers, and to make sure they know that we appreciate everything that they're doing for us at this time. And this song is about hope, and hope is something we can't lose when the world is in the midst of a pandemic. And I'm hoping I can instill a more positive outlook in you guys, and thank you for listening. Like a small boat on the ocean, sending big waves into motion, like how a single word can make a heart open. I might only have one match, but I can make an explosion. And all those things I didn't say, wrecking balls inside my brain, I will scream them loud tonight. Can you hear my voice this time? This is my fight song. Take back my life song. Prove I'm alright song. My power's turned on. Starting right now, I'll be strong. I'll play my fight song. And I don't really care if nobody else believes, 'cause I've still got a lot of fight left in me. Losing friends and I'm chasing sleep, everybody's worried about me. In too deep, say I'm in too deep. It's been 2 years, I miss my home. There's a fire burning in my bones. Still believe, yeah, I still believe. And all those things I didn't say, wrecking balls inside my brain, I will scream them loud tonight. Can you hear my voice this time? This is my fight song. Take back my life song. Prove I'm alright song. My power's turned on. Starting right now, I'll be strong. I'll play my fight song. And I don't really care if nobody else believes, 'cause I've still got a lot of fight left in me. A lot of fight left in me. Like a small boat on the ocean, sending big waves into motion, like how a single word can make a heart open. I might only have one match, but I can make an explosion. This is my fight song. Take back my life song. Prove I'm alright song. My power's turned on. Starting right now, I'll be strong. I'll play my fight song. And I don't really care if nobody else believes, 'cause I've still got a lot of fight left in me. Still got a lot of fight left in me.
Beautiful. It is not just the seva that you do. You're bringing up the talent. This is commendable. When, Meenalji was talking and saying the kids are using their talent to fund for the donations at Seva International. I mean, this was just amazing to know that. I mean, some kids are teaching dance or music, earning money out of that. And then they're donating their talent, the hard-earned money that they earn through their talent, they're donating to Seva International. Sarvopari hai wo seva, jo aap sikha rahe hain unhe. I will say that. Wo sarvopari hai, jo apne lalach se, apne khudi se, hat karke, un bachon ko aap sikha rahe hain, aur ye aisi achhi jadein aap bana rahe hain, such a strong foundation you are giving to those, youth basically, they will become the leaders of tomorrow. This is what we miss in the world otherwise. That empathy, that connect with people, that care, you know. If you are able to imbibe that value at this early age, this world will be full of great leaders, of great workers, of people who will care for each other. And I think we will have a great existence together.
So I do apologize. Meenanji had some more pictures, but I couldn't show it right now on the show. It
really?
Means Meenalji has to come back again on the show.
See, I must tell you one thing, Rajeshji and Meenalji. When I am doing this show, of course, the show is named as Community Spatial with Jyotsna. And I personally have a moral responsibility to bring the meaningful conversations and information and people to the fore. And humne sirf aagaz kiya hai. ये अंत तो नहीं होने वाला. अच्छे काम खत्म नहीं होते तो अच्छे लोगों को बुलाना है मेरे इस प्लेटफॉर्म पे तो जारी रहेगा. टुडे आई हैव कॉल्ड यू फॉर एन एक्स कॉज दैट वाज कोविड-19 एंड ऑफ कोर्स यू स्पोक अबाउट व्हाट आर द इनिशिएटिव्स यू आर टेकिंग. सो योर वर्क विल कीप गोइंग एंड इट विल कीप इंक्रीजिंग. और हम ऐसा कारवां आप लोगों के लिए जोड़ना चाहेंगे जहां हाथ से हाथ मिले, दिल से दिल मिले और आगे बढ़ते चले. ये हमारी मना टीवी की एक पहल रहेगी उसमें कि हम भी जुड़े अच्छे लोगों से, अच्छी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन से, और हम एक सामाजिक मैसेज जो है वो लोगों को दे सके. वी शुड बी एबल टू गिव अ ग्रेट मैसेज, अ मैसेज ऑफ सोशल रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी. एंड व्हेन वी अलाइन विद नॉन प्रॉफिट्स लाइक यू और गुड ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस लाइक यू, दैट्स वेयर वी फील अकम्प्लिश्ड, यू नो, एज एन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, एज एन मीडिया ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, दैट वी आर डूइंग सम मीनिंगफुल वर्क एज वेल. सो डेफिनेटली टुडे had been an introductory session where we got to know so much of detail about Seva International and HSS as an organization, such surprising facts about the kids being involved, the adults being involved, the kind of drives you do, the kind of drives you do worldwide, the kind of branches you have all over. And of course, it's a never-ending process because the kind of help you want to extend to people, you have different sections there, different reasons and different subjects, you know, where people can go all out and help. So I look forward to have Meenalji again on the platform. And we would definitely like to bring some leaders from HSS as well as an organization, sure, where we would like to connect with some youth. And we should have some input from them as well. Mm-hmm. There are some contentious issues that need to be discussed through the youth platform, through the youth channel, because we have heard about some racism being happening in the university level and where the brown-skilled kids, you know, or the Hindu kids, or brown-skinned, you know, kids have faced some kind of racial, you know, interference. I mean, there is some problem that has come up, you know, some bullying happens or something else happens. So for that reason, we also need to bring those kind of issues and discuss about them. It's all about community. People are not aware about those things, what happened in the universities, and we got to know about such things happening through some other organization, related organization, but yes, as it is, HSS, yes, we would like to have inputs from you, from your youth wing as well about that.
Sure.
And of course, about the leadership programs that you run. So Rajeshji, if you want to sum up the entire things about HSS, about Seva International, again, to reiterate your connect, your website, your telephone number, and a few other things that are coming up, you know, recent, like in the next few days. Just speak about that so that my people are aware about that.
Yes. So first event, which we are working on right now, is for Sunday, this Sunday, 31st of May, mm-hmm, on Oak Tree Road behind the Chili. We will be doing a drive-through food distribution. We are expecting about 500 packets of food that we will distribute. I would request, if you know somebody, please spread the word. Our number is 702-900-SEWA. 702-900-SEWA. They can call us to get more information. We have brochures all over the place, Facebook and few townships. And you will see on some township pages that this flyer is going around. Any information you need, or you can tweet us at Jersey Seva. That's J-E-R-S-E-Y-S-E-W-A, Jersey Seva, at Jersey Seva on Twitter. and also Save Us Central Jersey on Facebook. With that, I thank you, Joshanaji, for inviting us on this platform to spread the word. Hopefully, a few more families could come and take advantage of our drive on Sunday.
Thank you so much, Rajesh Ji, and thank you so much, Meenal Ji, for a very valuable session that we had with you today. And in fact, yes, positivity will come in the lives of many other people now that they know whom to connect with, whom to call when in distress, all those elderly people who are at home, all those people who are still sick, you know, whom to call. Now they know they can simply call Seva and they can get some groceries and other life items, you know, delivered to their home. All those small businesses who are willing to open their offices, those medical professionals, they also know now whom to connect with to get those basic PPE kits and start off again, you know, and start earning their livelihood. So thank you so much for your valuable time. And my dear viewers, this was the conversation with Seva International, and of course, with the leader from HSS, Hindu Swayam Sevak Sangh. So Meenal Ji and Rajesh Sharma Ji were there with us in the conversation today. I hope you might have gained a lot of good information from them. And I'm very positive that you might want to involve your children in the good activities that they are doing. As of today, we will sign off, but we'll come back again with another important, another enlightening, another some special topic to discuss. For our community, my commitment will stay the strongest as it has been, and I will be there for you to bring more happy lives for you. Thank you on behalf of Mana TV and Mana TV International.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Namaste.